Brings up fourth down, and they're going to go for it. Martin and Wells out of the eye. Wells over the right side, got the first down. He may have a touchdown. He's gone. Touchdown, Ohio State. Jonathan Wells, 46 yards for his second touchdown of the afternoon. State is rolling early in the second here in Ann Arbor.
Quarterback run. Miller's got the 15. Miller inside the 5. Touchdown, Buckeyes! A 19-yard touchdown run. The seventh rushing score for the true freshman, Braxton Miller. Braxton Miller, true freshman. First true freshman Ohio State quarterback to start at Michigan Stadium.
They now need 7 yards for the first down. Smith in trouble, spins away from it. 40, 45, 50, 35. Troy Smith emerging as the Buckeye leader with a 46-yard run as he spins away from trouble. Leon Hall finally gets the job done. Lloyd Carr and the Wolverines in a ton of trouble.
You can see Marlon Jackson's playing bump and run. These receivers run off. There's going to be a 7-man rush on this play, and the play is made by the quarterback. He can't play any better defense than this. Spins away from the defense. There's Marlon Jackson. He's got his man. All of a sudden, he turns around and says, what is going on here? That play.
Pocket, not inside the pocket. When he's inside, he rushes himself. Like
he's in the pocket,
right here.
He's in trouble. He dropped the ball in the end zone. Free at the goal line. And it looks like Cameron Hayward has it for an Ohio State touchdown.
Well, Sean, you said it. He was right there in the pocket. And that's where he has struggled the most. I don't know if he doesn't see things well, but the one thing I do know is he loses his patience inside, and he starts to pull his eyes down like you see right there.
And he's not very good with ball security. We've seen that.
Wednesday, but boy, they have come in here with a sense of purpose.
And Rudock goes down, and it's Bosa, and the ball's out, and I think Ohio State might have this one covered. Tommy Shutt, I think, is the guy in the football. The Bosa effect again, and Rudock's hurt. They didn't officially give him a sack the last time he decked the quarterback because it was right at the line of scrimmage. This one will be a sack, a fumble, and an injured Wolverine all in one swoop.
Well, and they went to an unbalanced line, so this is not a tight end. That's Mason Cole. A starting tackle, but he's normally the left tackle. He lined up as the right tackle, and Bosa went right around him and got to the quarterback and knocked the ball loose. You know, it's definitely a mismatch if you put a tight end over Joey Bosa, but you think you might have a chance.
Miller play action fake, wants to go deep, has a man running open. It is caught inside the 10 and down Devin Smith at the 8-yard line. Tackled by JT Floyd.
51 yards.
Sean, this is exactly what we talked about. Jordan Kovacs, number 11, is inside the box. You have the safety up where you're going to attack deep down the middle of the field, just like.
Tight end in motion. Ezekiel Elliott got to the edge this time, and there he goes. Elliott in a foot race. They'll track him down, but he gets all the way to the 11-yard line. Much like he did the final three games of last year, ripping off big runs on the way to the national title, and this one's good for 66 yards.
Great block by both tight ends. One came in, Nick Bennett came out to lead the play.
Six, which is the mark in 1986. Gardner lost the football as he wound up, and it is being ruled a fumble and a recovery by Zach Bourne of Ohio State.
Number 92, Washington's going to come from the outside, and I love the fact that he does not go for the kill shot, but he goes for the strip and beat him with speed. Zach Bourne, of course, the former fullback, now starting middle linebacker, comes in with a big recovery.
Boy, Adolphus Washington, the true freshman, is certainly being held by
Hoke's tenure at Michigan be over after four seasons. Here comes a blitz. It's picked up. Gardner, though, is wrapped up by Bosa. The ball's out. Darren Lee's got it for Ohio State. Going for the exclamation point. Touchdown, Buckeyes. Second fumble recovery for a touchdown this year by Darren Lee. And it's 20 unanswered points. About to become 21 straight.
You think about 10 minutes ago in this game, JT Barrett's laying on the field of Ohio Stadium, and it's a one-score game. And now, 10 minutes later, this team is up, gonna go up 20 points in this game. And all of a sudden, the style points are there.
42-21 with 4 minutes to go.
They've struggled to block this defensive line for Ohio State all game. And when you combine that with holding the football, it's a recipe for disaster. Bosa's going to come off the edge. He's done it all game long. Gets a hand on the football, and then Lee, the true freshman, the beneficiary, picks it up, and that's a microcosm of Michigan season all year long. You just, once you pump that ball, especially in a game like this where you know you've been pressured all game, once you pump that ball.
With White leading the way, breaking free again. Touchdown, Ohio State. This time, it's Antonio Pittman. The first half belonged to Chris Wells, but they explode the middle again. 56 yards for the junior, and the Akron Twins, Pittman and Chris Wells, have done the job.
Well, first of all, Steve Rearing, number 71, comes around on the power play and gets a block. Keep in mind, this is the number one rush defense in all of college football. Once they crease the line of scrimmage, you see number 22, Jamar Adams, the safety, up so close. There's no one in the second level of defense. And once Kirkey broke the line of scrimmage, he was gone.
Well, it was about speed and acceleration once he got through that initial surge for the Michigan defense. But I think Michigan put nine.
Elliott has the first.
it to the house. A 44-yard touchdown sprint by Ezekiel Elliott, and the Buckeyes have a 2-touchdown lead.
The courage to make the big decision to go for it on fourth down in the fourth quarter for Urban Meyer is rewarded. In this game, fourth quarter is all that really matters. And if you have the courage to make that call and execute it to perfection, you got a great chance of winning the football game. And that's what happened.
35-21, Ohio State, under five to play. Great blocking up front. Ryan can't get the ankle tackle, and Ezekiel Elliott into the end zone. Urban Meyer's team up two scores late.
And a spinning move, breaking free, headed for the end zone, Chris Wells. 52 yards. The young man known as Beanie, the freshman and the most heavily recruited running back in the country, Chris Wells, ignites a fire.
Outside of him from the shotgun. Smith in the protective pocket. Could not find a receiver. Now goes downfield. Gonzalez got it. Touchdown. Buckeyes strike. Anthony Gonzalez coming off his first start a week ago. 68 yards. And the offensive line did a superb job of giving Smith just enough time to get the ball off.
Just a three-man rush for Michigan. 5-6 Ohio State players blocking three from Michigan. That allowed Troy to stay in that pocket too long for Michigan.
Bring you where he's from.
Rashawn Crable from the outside. Boom, right there. Would love to have a chance back at this play because he could have had Beanie Wells tackled for a loss, but he's able to get through that initial contact, and then it was just a big hole that opened up through the middle of that Michigan defense. And how about the speed, Coach, that he showed in the open field for a big man?
And that's what surprises me at 235 pounds. Had 99 yards last week against Northwestern, and the best thing, he didn't fumble.
Play fake, and Miller on the rollout, looking downfield. Oh my goodness, a man is standing wide open. It's a touchdown for Corey Brown. Michigan fell asleep in the secondary. The first touchdown for Corey Brown, 54 yards. There was not a Michigan defender within 20 yards of him.
There's a reason why a state guy has been throwing the football to Devere Posey, number 8. He's going to come in, and you'll see Michigan defenders jump him. Look at the safety right there, jumping Devere Posey. You have two guys on Devere Posey leaving that half of the field wide open. Not enough room for the backside safety to get to. And Braxton Miller, staying patient, saw the safety jump, vacate his responsibility, leaving Philly Brown wide open for 6.
He dropped one last week on a long ball, made up for it with a touchdown grab, the 10th touchdown pass for Braxton Miller this year. And
nice play fake, and Pryor wants it all. Going long, got a man and got him. Touchdown, Hartline. set. Pryor's going to be fine if he just calms down. He calmed down and threw a rocket right here. 53 yards right on the money.
Just a little post pattern. Man coverage. The middle is free. It's a great throw there.
Sure was.
Deion Smith lined up in his end zone. They fake it to him. Spate gets the throw away. Intercepted. And another pick six for the Ohio State defense. Malik Hooker just walks in.
Boy, a gutsy call by Jim Harbaugh. Play action pass, which has worked most this game, but this time back deep into his own territory. And Ohio State brought pressure. They brought their linebackers, so Hooker comes up with a pick with his eyes on the ball. But the two linebackers, Baker and Raekwon McMillan, caused it.
Sixth pick for Hooker leads the team. And their seventh pick six of the season. Third for him, McMillan provided the pressure, and just like that, Ohio State, after a pretty dismal first half offensively, takes the lead with the defensive touchdown.
They bring the two linebackers. Baker's already walked up. McMillan's who ends up getting to the quarterback, but watch the running back and Smith and how unclear he is and what to do here. Ends up getting the pressure. Hooker's right here with his eyes on the quarterback. The ball just goes up in the air. And there's Hooker, who's been doing it all year.
Offense, they come up to the line quickly. Forcier the fake. Nifty move. Throws! Oh. Intercepted! Devon Torrence! Another critical error by Michigan.
But well played by Devon Torrence. Go back to the first touchdown for Michigan, and it was because Forcier bought time with his feet. This time, he buys a little bit more time and comes back to his left side, but watch Torrence, number 10. Eyes are still back inside, still takes a sneaks a peek where the receiver is, and then makes a nice break on the ball.
Forcier turned it over four times today. He had the fumble into the end zone that led to an Ohio State
empty backfield. And there he goes on the quarterback draw. And he's into the secondary. Great move. And now the speed in the middle of the field looking for a stiff arm. Touchdown, Ohio State. What a run. The second 53-yard touchdown of the first quarter. One by his arm and that one by his feet. Longest run allowed by Michigan this year. Drew Basil in for the point after. Up and good. 55 seconds remaining in the quarter.
Well,
Braxton Carlos, Miller, something else.
Carlos Hyde's going to run over you. Braxton Miller is going to make you look foolish when he gets you in the open field. He makes two guys miss. Watch the first guy, Heintzman, number 92. He makes him miss, and then right in the middle of the field. You got no chance. If you're this guy right here and he can go either way on you, you got no chance. It's Courtney Avery. See ya. Touchdown, Ohio State.
Puts a stiff arm out at the end and dives into the end zone. And that is his sixth scoring run of the year. And none more impressive than that one.
Like I said, they're the two best running backs in the Big
with Denard Robinson also on the field. Forcier's going deep, and it is incomplete.
Intercepted.
And intercepted. They wanted a call. Kurt Coleman came away with the ball. He was looking for Denard Robinson. The Ohio State fans celebrating. The interception by Coleman, his fourth of the year.
Well, we said neither of these teams really pushed the ball, and now they take Denard Robinson, who has some juice, and there's some jostling going on down there with number five, Jim DeChicco. But Coleman tracks the ball well. And because Chekwa was able to tip it right at the end, Coleman comes down with the pick. The ball, of course, was underthrown. Had it been pushed over the
third down, 35-yard line, nearing 12 minutes to go. Ohio State leads by 11. Forsyth throws it up for grabs, and it is intercepted. And now ruled incomplete. Kurt Coleman thought he had it. He held it up for the official, but ruled out of bounds.
Well, and I think it's because, or I believe it's because he got control under it, which allowed him to be able to make that this play right here. That's a lot of ground to cover for Coleman, and really, that's a good catch. That's a pick.
It sure looked like it, I thought, live, but it does after the replays as well.
Matthews tried to do the transition game. He tried to do it well, tried to be a defender. But Coleman just makes a good play.
Kurt Coleman, the senior. One game with an interception.
After further review, the defender had firm possession of the ball with a foot down inbounds. We have an interception. Ohio State's ball, first down at the 6-yard line.
I want to show you how he got there. They were showing a cover three first, and then they rolled to a cover two. This would look like it would be a traditional 1-2-3, but what they do is they roll it up. He comes over, he goes to half and half, and Coleman has a lot of real estate, and he anticipates it very well. You can see how he rolls to it and then tracks it, and it makes a great play.
Simple as that. Beanie Wells got an opening, might be gone. Beanie, 20, 10, goodbye. The longest play from scrimmage this year for Ohio State. Beanie Wells, 59-yard touchdown. That got the crowd awake. Ryan Pretorius in for the extra point. It's good. So one play after a nice punt by Michigan. Finally, we have some offense in the person of Beanie Wells.
Jim Bowman, the offensive coordinator, got together and says that this is what they're doing. Watch the block that Cordo's going to get right up the center. Cordo pulls around, gets the block on the middle linebacker, and right up the middle.
You notice, Greece, that they ran that blitz about the fourth or fifth time they've run that play, and it wasn't going anywhere. But this team, they know about Beanie Wells, and they know how good their offensive line is. And what they did is they just kept pounding it, pounding it, pounding it, and then finally Beanie Wells breaks it in the clear for the touchdown.
Beanie goes over 1,000 yards on that run. Back-to-back 1,000 yards.
Two times they handled the football, but now, ever since, every drive has ended with a punt. Again, he thought Holmes was going to step over, then he makes the catch on it. Ginn swings free. Look out now. Can Finley get an angle? Down the sideline. Forget about it. This baby's over this race. That's 82 yards on the return. And as we said at the top of this broadcast, he could be the most dangerous freshman in college football.
We talked about fast. We talked about faster. Braylon Edwards right there, not handling the punt coverage very well. A receiver did not break down, ran right by Teddy Ginn, and there's no way Finley was going to catch Teddy Ginn. That's the
Miller gonna air it out long. He's got a man out there. Got him. Devin Smith. Touchdown. Spot than he just put it on that touchdown pass. Drew Basil in for the point after. And we're tied in Ann Arbor. 5:08 remaining in the first quarter. Braxton 75-yard drive. Excuse me, Ledge.
Braxton Miller missed Devin Smith in the first possession. Not this time. Excellent.
For Devin
combination.
Smith. That's touchdown number 8, and it's tied at 7.
Seth Brookhuysen kicks off short down to Jordan Hall at the 15-yard line. Up the numbers, and he is into the clear. One man to get him. Jordan Hall. Touchdown, Ohio State, 85 yards. Just 12 seconds after the Michigan touchdown, Jordan Hall responds. Sophomore from Gwinnett, Pennsylvania, former high school teammate of Terrell Pryor. The extra point by Barkley pushes the lead right back to 10 points for Ohio State.
Well, Hall just follows the block of Jamal Berry, number 4. Watch him. Berry right there. Boom! That's a great job. Boren right here. And look at the lane he has to run through. When you're a kick returner and you see that much green with no white jerseys in front, you just let your eyes do the running. Nice cutback at the end, and it's 6.
First kickoff return for a touchdown this year for Ohio State. Ray Smallbrown back against Wisconsin for a touchdown last year. Again, the kick.
Kansas. Talk about a showdown next Saturday night. Oh, Henny is hit by number 50. Vernon Golston stunned him.
Well, as much as we've talked about Beanie Wells on the offensive side, the story for the Ohio State defense, the entire group, but really it's been Vernon Golston. What happened that time, Brent, is the receiver that he wanted to throw the football to Adrian Aaron.
Four. First and 10, the Wolverines from their own 38. Look out! Zach Boren levels Gardner back inside the 30. Another tradition in this rivalry, some hard hits, and we've seen a bunch here in the first half.
Zach Boren comes in on a late delayed blitz. Again, set off the deep ball off the play action. This time it's covered downfield well. Then Zach Boren comes in with the finish. When we talk about one step and wrap, two step and squeeze, and run through your target. We've seen that on both sides of the football.
Buckeye fans in our hotel were talking about that last night already. But they, oh, and Joey Bosa comes up with the ball, stiff arms, and gets down to the 10-yard line.
He's a great football player.
Such an impact in so many different ways.
I mean, he's reading it. See, he's not rushing right away. His eyes are on the quarterback the whole time, and then just makes an athletic play.
Tipped it to himself, the tip drill for Joey Bosa. First turnover of the game.
State backed up to its own 2-yard line, first and 10. Boom, Heron through the line, then broke a tackle, trying to go 98. He will do it. Touchdown, 98 yards.
Dane Sonzenbacher with a great effort.
Flag down at the 9-yard line.
Oh, that's, hey, Sonzenbacher was blocking James Rogers, and it was a fight going back and forth. And he fought him from about the 30-yard line in.
Holding, number 12.
Wow.
Offense, 10-yard penalty, spot of the foul. Still, first and 10, Ohio State.
Sonzenbacher had a remarkable job. Look down the field from the 50 on in. He's pushing. They're pushing each other. I'm not.
Well, the flag was at the 9, so I guess there's the hold. But wow.
Who's holding who there?
Coming out now from the 37-yard line. Steady diet. Beanie Wells breaks past midfield, breaks into the clear, foot race for the end zone. 6 on the board for the Buckeyes. 62 yards. So you call back a 65-yarder, you snap it, and you go 62 for the touchdown. Ron English has to be furious about this run. Lloyd Carr went right down to his defensive coordinator right after that play. And you can see how angry the defensive coordinator is. Watch this. I'm showing you why he could become a great one someday.
NFL coaching for a long time. He's now receiver coach for the Cleveland Browns.
Second down, powering ahead. Great fake. Wide open. Ginn. Touchdown, Ohio State. And it was off a beautiful fake by Troy Smith. A 39-yard explosion.
Time you have a back that's had a pretty good game, and Wells, the safety and the linebackers came up. Ryan Mundy gets out of position. They worked on this play, I'm sure, all week in practice. Teddy Ginn one-on-one for the touchdown.
And you better bump Ted Ginn at the line of scrimmage. You let him off, I don't care how fast you are, you aren't going to catch him.
Timeout in Columbus.
Upset. Gardner, right side, it's intercepted. Ohio State intercepts it. Tyvus Powell saves the season. Can you believe it? Those folks can't.
Well, Gardner was looking for Dillio, his possession receiver. Ohio State was locked in on number 9. They had him bracketed. And Tyvus Powell came from the inside and made the interception. Gardner had time. He just didn't have an open guy.
Brad.
Braxton Miller with a
first down and 10. The offensive line has done a great job. Smith dances away from trouble. On the run, caught by Gonzalez inside the 5-yard line. Gonzalez may have made the biggest catch of the year for the Buckeyes. 26 yards, and Anthony Gonzalez does it.
After Houdini got out of the pocket, he looked downfield. Gonzalez went deep on Grant Mason, and you could see it. Caught the ball down there. Ohio State only has one timeout, so Michigan takes the timeout here as they get it. Watch Houdini. Watch Houdini right here. The pocket collapses on him. He bounces inside. He wants to run. It gets collapsed with David Harris, number 45, so he bounces back outside, and the worst fear of the Michigan Wolverines, a scrambling quarterback, makes the play and delivers a perfect throw. Watch Gonzalez to the outside. He breaks his route. It was just a quick out, but then he sees quarterback Troy Smith get out of the pocket. He goes deep exactly the way you're taught. When you're the near side receiver to a scrambling quarterback, you go long, and it's exactly what he did. A well-coached and a well-thrown ball, and look at Gonzalez. He comes up with it. I tell you, Brent, he's one of the most underrated players on this team.
Now,
Samuel cuts it back. Ohio State wins. Down. Michigan fumbled at the 1-yard line. Here's the winning play, Kirk.
Well, Curtis Samuel, we talked about in the first half, where's he been? Yeah, the flow of the defense, you're trying to contain him because of his speed, but he shows his natural ability as a runner, sensing that. We saw it on that crazy play on third down. This time he felt it. There's that acceleration. That's what makes him so dangerous in the open field. But he had that quiet first half, finally found his way, especially in overtime.
Urban Meyer.
One second left on the clock.
Remember, it is not a home timekeeper anymore. That was a change this year. It's an independent play. They are running the clock. The ball sails out, and the independent clock operator says one more snap.
So close, and yet so far. The ball will be in Navarre's hands one last time. Fires in zone, intercepted. Let's party, Columbus. Their 29th Big Ten championship, and it is huge as Maurice Clarett, Jim Tressel, and the Buckeyes were ahead to Arizona, where they'll play for all the Tostitos in the Fiesta Bowl on January 3rd.